What's up guys, it's your girl Renee from RG Mode and I am back with another video. My previous, I think, video was a sneaker haul and I'm back with another one. The last sneaker haul was basically all of the sneakers that I accumulated over the pandemic, well at least the beginning portion of our like insane pandemic. So I have three piles in front of me and the three piles consist of Nike Jordans, Nike brand shoes, Converse and Adidas. And I know Converse technically is a Nike, in the Nike umbrella, but I just kind of put them off to the side because they weren't like the true Nikes. And for reference, I typically wear a 7 or a 7.5 men's or youth, depending on the width of the shoe. Sometimes a 7 or a 7.5 youth definitely is a little more narrow, so I typically will go for a men's versus a youth. But if there is a youth only, your girl gonna figure it out, okay? So jumping right in, the first box that I see is these Jordan 4s. This is the box. And I am typically not a person who keeps boxes. I used to. I think that it's dope to have the boxes if you have the space and storage for them. But for me, I don't always keep my boxes. I typically will like put it on a shelf, and I am in the process of updating how I store my sneakers and my heels and stuff, so stay tuned for that. The first sneaker I'm going to show you is the Jordan 4. This is the fire red Jordan 4. I love this sneaker. First of all, it's very classic. I love the white, it pops, and then that pop of red, you know, I just think this is a dope shoe. There's not really much to say about it, and I'm so happy I got my hands on these guys. But yeah, I even wore these yesterday for Valentine's Day with these super cute like heart sheer socks that I got from Forever 21. Yo, it was a look, okay? And if you're not following my Instagram, definitely go follow it because I definitely feature all of my sneakers on my page. If not on my page, I do have a section in my highlights reel or highlights portion of my stories where you can see my sneakers. And I believe it's called My Kicks. And it's like My Kicks 1, My Kicks 2, My Kicks 3. I believe these are my first 4s that I've ever had. I've never had a 4. The Spizike is very similar to a 4. And I've had a couple of the Spike Lee Jordans, fire red Jordan 4s I ended up getting from Nike. So the next Jordan is this one right here. And these are the Jordan 1s. Now, this is a newer purchase. Literally, I think I bought these last week. So it is the Volt. I haven't even laced them up. I have not even worn them. That's how new they are. These are the Volts. A lot of people were on the fence about this sneaker because it has the two tones. So you have this like kind of like almost like a Lakers yellowish golden color, and then you have this Volt color, and it's like so strange to have the two. I love this tongue though. I love that it has this like more like plasticky kind of situation on the tongue, and that the inside says Nike Air like that. Super cute. I was saying, like, I was like, if I get these shoes, I'm probably gonna customize them and then I can just like take off the yellow. But to be honest, like after like for real looking at them, I would not want to change. I don't know, I don't think I want to change anything because the tongue definitely flows with the back. I was thinking either the yellow should go away or the Volt should go away. I don't know, but I'm kind of feeling them and I can't wait to rock them. I just haven't done so yet. The Jordan 1 Volts I got from Stadium Goods. The next Jordan I got are these. These are the Flints. These are the Jordan 13s. And it's these guys right here. I really don't have a lot of like blues in my shoe collection, I noticed. So I definitely was happy to add this to the collection. These are giving me very like neutral vibes as well. And sometimes I like to like wear a lot of neutrals and kind of like spice it up a little bit with a sneaker. So I love a good gray. I love the blue. I just love the Flint. The Flints I got from Stadium Goods. The next Jordan I have to show you guys are these. They're actually a little beat up because I wore these to a lounge like a week ago. I got my wipes right here because honestly, like, that's not cute. That's just not cute. But these are Jordan 1 Lows. A friend of mine actually put me onto these. I actually have some similar in the exact same silhouette, except it does not have the mohair here. They're just an all black Jordan 1 High, and she was like, oh, you know, you probably should get these. They're only $20. They were like $23 from the Nike store. Like I said, these have the mohair on the side. So they removed the swoosh and just replaced it with like a mohair. I've worn these twice so far, I believe. And both times I kind of dressed it up. I wore it with like a jumpsuit. And then the next time I wore them with some like leather trousers. So I feel like a shoe like this is really great to like dress up anything, but you want to still kind of give that casual look. The next sneaker is right here, and yet again, I definitely need to wipe these off because you guys know I live in Chicago and it is literally a snowstorm every other day, and I was caught outside with these shoes on in the snow. They are patent leather. These are the Jordan 11 cap and gown, so of course they have the patent on them, so it's easy to clean, it's easy to kind of like just, you know, if you get caught in the rain or whatever, like you don't feel too bad because obviously like it's the patent leather in the shoe. But yeah, these are the cap and gown. I wanted the Jubilees that came out literally maybe last month sometime, and instead I got these from Nike, and I love that they're all black, and I felt like I needed to add more black shoes into my collection because I have a lot of different colors or shoes that have incorporated a little bit of black here and there, but I needed some like true black shoes. The next and final Jordan that I have is this guy right here, and these are the Jordan 1 Zoom. Now I got these back I believe in August actually, and so this is like my oldest of the newest shoes that I have, and it's these right here. I love these. First of all, I had never had a Zoom before. They're not your traditional retro one. However, the Zoom is so comfortable. If you're a person who don't like to wear sneakers because you feel like they're uncomfortable or your feet always hurt or something like that, try on a Zoom. There is so much padding. You can't quite see that, but it's cushioning inside of here. It's crazy. And there's a couple of Zooms that are either out already that are still in stores like Foot Locker and Foot Action and stuff like that. Probably can get it from Nike as well, but there are some Zooms coming out and I feel like they got my name on it. You know what I'm saying? I gotta get it. Now what I will say is, because I'm traditionally more of a 7 or 7.5, a lot of Zooms, if they're not a woman's Zoom, if they're a men's Zoom, they start at a size 8, which is not ideal for someone who has smaller feet, so that kind of sucks. But the 8 actually fits pretty comfortable. I think it's because of the way that the toe box is created and made, like it's just kind of a more like snugger fit. I did try on another Zoom I want to say like 2-3 weeks ago, and the 8 was a little too big and I couldn't get them. I couldn't make myself purchase something that just didn't fit right. So yeah, but I love these. I think the colorway is great. My favorite color is green. Like this is popping. And it comes with a second pair of laces as well, which is always, you know, a dope thing. So now moving along to my Nikes. I got some Nike ID. I've always wanted to Nike ID some shoes, customize some shoes through the Nike app, and I just kind of sometimes shy away from it, or I play around with the app and never really like go through with the purchase. So I actually did, and I have some Nike by me, and it says Nike by you on it. And let me show y'all. These are the Air Force One and Pendleton collab. And this is the shoe. Look at these, y'all. It has every neutral I love in this shoe, okay? This shoe is so bomb. So it also has like a cute little tab on here, and it has my initials, which is RJG. Love it. Also my brand, RG, you already know. And I just love, 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 love this shoe. It's just so like bomb. This is like all the aesthetic, okay? My entire wardrobe matches this shoe. So yeah, I was super excited to like actually finally do a Nike ID. Y'all, if you ever get the chance, do a Nike ID. Make something custom, you know, create something that is going to be unique for you. No one else is really going to have it. They may have a variation of something similar because obviously the color choices are limited, you know, when you do those Nike IDs. But at the same time, it's just really dope, you know. And you can say, like, I created a Nike shoe through the Nike app, you know, and who's to know, who's to say that they won't pick up your design and then sell it? How crazy would that be? The next Nike shoe that I have is the Blazer. This is the Blazer Mid 77 Vintage. I used to be such a Blazer advocate. Like, back in the day, the sneakers that I would wear were Nike Dunks and Nike Blazers. Literally, I had almost every flavor there was, okay? And it's so crazy that over the years, I've still kept some of my Blazers, but I've gotten rid of so many different, like, types of shoes over the years, and I just, like, regret it because it's so funny that things come full circle all the time. So now Blazers and Dunks and stuff like that are so, like, the wave right now. So I picked these up because these are a newer, like, silhouette. Is definitely not that old school, like, silhouette, and y'all see me wiping down my shoes as I show y'all, but yeah, they love my shoe. I mean, I've been wearing them, y'all. I need to, like, go through all my sneakers and clean them, but this is the Nike Blazer. It is in the colorway, let's see, velvet brown and boarwood brown. Such a great, like, this is such a great neutral. It's such a great shoe to wear in the fall, winter time. I absolutely love, like, how the leather is, like, buttery. It's just a really beautiful shoe. And I just feel like I said, my aesthetic is very much neutrals. I love neutrals, even though I wear bright colors here and there, but I'm such a sucker for a good neutral, and I love a good brown. They also came with a second pair of laces, which is this really beautiful orange, and orange and brown look so good together, and it's such a fall, like, collab. Let me show y'all. I bought these socks too that, like, I was gonna wear, and I still am, even though it's not fall anymore. It's definitely winter now, but I just bought these, like, fall leaf socks with this orange lace. Like, you see it, right? You girl, would you be quiet? Okay, like, this is just a bomb little look. And I mean, I don't have to wear it now. I could wear it later or whatever. But yeah, so I just thought, you know, I'd add the newer silhouette of the Blazer into my collection. There's a couple other Blazers I'm thinking about getting. And I also want to get some all white Blazers and customize them myself. The last, like, Nike shoe that I got are these. This is the Air Max 1. This is the Air Max 1 Anniversary in the color white and evergreen. This green, let me just show y'all. I'm gonna stop talking and just show y'all. Boom. This is literally one of my favorite greens. Like, I just like how it's, like, foresty, evergreen. The name of it is definitely, like, true. Like, it's an evergreen type of foresty, really beautiful, kind of matches my drapes type of colorway. I love this colorway. First of all, Air Max 1s have become easily one of my favorite type of Nikes. I have collected over the years so many Air Max 1 premiums and Air Max 1 supremes, and, like, just, like, I just love this. It just is such a classic look, and it just looks really good with any type of style. You can dress these up or down. I just, yeah, this, it's gonna forever be a favorite, okay? Now, moving on to the Converse, I have these, which, first of all, they're not everyone's cup of tea. This is the Ambush collab with Converse. This is, I believe, the Converse 70. Don't quote me. I don't have the box, which is unfortunate. So the left shoe has the Ambush kind of patch on the back. It is in this beautiful blue fluff. And then it has the Converse patch on the inside, like normal. The tongue is this fur, which is really cool. I think they're pretty dope. They also come in a black color, so it's the black fur with the white. Yeah, so the left side has this Ambush on the back, and then the right side actually has this patch, which is just the, like, Converse kind of patch. And then it also still has the, you know, patch in the inside. But yeah, they're super comfortable, obviously warm as well. I mean, there's no fur in the inside. However, wearing these, I just felt comfy cozy. They are, like I said, not everyone's cup of tea, but that's fine because I tend to wear things that kind of push the envelope anyway. These sneakers have been on my radar for a very long time. I want to get a couple of other styles as well. This is the, I want to say the right name. I don't think that I know it by heart, but I'm going to put it right here. But these, I believe, are the Sky Highs. If not, I think they're similar to the Sky Highs. And I just love these sneakers. So it's like a gray taupe kind of color. And then the laces are this baby pink. And it's like a sweater material, which is really cute. Ugh. Sorry, my phone been going off, y'all. It's like a sweater material on the laces, which is nice. And then in the inside, there is this pink, baby pink fur, which is bomb. Of course, it's very like winter weather appropriate. I mean, I wouldn't be out here in the snow in these because of the colorway and the laces and the fur. I just kind of feel like I wouldn't want to ruin it. However, if it's just cold outside, this is a great shoe for you. These are just bomb. I love a good platform too. I'm really into that chunkier kind of heel height. It gives me height. I am only 5'4", so I love a good height in my shoe sometimes. But yeah, they're just beautiful. I just love them. So I got both of these Converse from the Converse outlet store in Rosemont here in Illinois. So these next shoes I'm going to show you are actually a black owned designer, Chicagoan, Chicago socialite type of person. He is Vic Lloyd. He is a part of like Fat Tiger. He also is a DJ, all kind of stuff or whatever. And so I love to support black entrepreneurs, especially Chicagoans. And I picked up his most recent Adidas collab. And you guys know when I All-Star Weekend last year, I got all of the Chicago Adidas, and okay, I had to add this to the collection, of course. Did I show you on the box already? But it says on the box still the Chicago 2020, because these did come out the tail end of last year. So what's dope about this sneaker is that it also comes with multiple things, okay, from laces to straps. Okay, so these are the original straps that come on the sneaker. I will like show y'all some videos of me wearing my shoes, I'm sure you guys see. But it comes with these straps. It comes with a like vault lime green type of color. It comes with a super bright neon orange color. It comes with even a black strap. And then even the last one is like this baby blue kind of like turquoisey blue color, which is really nice. The laces it comes with, of course, the already neutral kind of peachy toned orange lace, but it also comes with a very bright neon lace, and then also this kind of like a white with a gray stripe lace. Both of those super dope. I don't think it comes to anything else, but yeah, I had to pick these up. Now, this particular Adidas silhouette is called the Forum Low. I am not super familiar with Adidas. Like, I just got into Adidas literally during the pandemic, like, or technically during All-Star Weekend of last year. But yeah, I don't know. I kind of been like incorporating a couple of different type of Adidas into my collection, and these are very comfortable. I think they're sold out now, but you can definitely get this style, I believe, on the Adidas website or go to the Adidas store and they have a similar style, but I think these may be sold out. You may be able to get your hands on these maybe on Stadium or StockX, possibly check. For the last pair, which is very controversial, I got some Yeezys. You guys know my last haul, I shared with you guys the Yeezy 350 Ultra, what is it, Boost, whatever. Those are comfortable. They're not super practical because they are a lighter color. I got the linen, and you know, obviously it's not a winter style shoe, but it also, I don't know, I just feel like dust and dirt kind of collects on there, and I don't want for them to get super dirty. So I got these, and I got these 500s in the attempt to wear them as a boot. I throw these on like how a girl would throw on an UGG. I'm not even kidding y'all. Like, I throw these on with leggings. I put them on with jeans. I just throw them on like a boot. This is the Yeezy 500. I believe the color is slate. Let me get the right color for y'all. Yes, this is the slate pair. There is also a like brown with like a blue color, but there is also two, I think, new colorways that just came out, which I kind of have my eye on and I'm thinking about getting, because the 500 is comfy. So you guys see like this padding, like how fluffy it is. When I tell y'all, that's how it feels on my foot. Like literally, like I feel like it's covered in a pillow. Like, I don't know, like something about this is very comfortable, but it's also super like sturdy and chunky, and I just feel like I can just wear these and not have to think twice about like my foot being cold or anything. Like, I don't know, and it's just a good gunmetal like grayish bluish tint, so it can go with a lot of different things. And yeah, I don't have anything bad to say. I know people like don't like these shoes, and someone was telling me that they're called the Rat. I don't know about that, okay, but whatever. And yes, they are dirty from me wearing them. Thank you guys for watching my sneaker haul. If you did not see the previous one that I did, I think it was like over the summer, I will have that one linked down below. I share with you guys all the sneakers that I bought during the pandemic. And now this sneaker haul is all about the shoes that I've accumulated over the course of like 6 months or so. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. I will try to post a bit more fashion and home stuff in between the vlogs. I know that I've been very vlog focused as of late, but yeah, let me know also what your favorite sneaker that I have purchased and I added to my collection is, and I will let you guys know my favorite as well down below to talk about it. Also, what are you excited about that's going to drop this year? Let me know what sneakers y'all are looking forward to, because I got a few of my own that I'm like waiting and hoping, and like hoping that, you know, the sneaker guys are on my side. If you are not subscribed to my channel, you should definitely subscribe to the channel. Other than that, I will see you in my next probably vlog video or upcoming video. So stay tuned. All right, see you guys in the next one. Bye.